Stridor is a sound that no healthcare professional ever wants to hear. It is a sign of airway obstruction that could be life-threatening and requires immediate medical assessment. Stridor can be heard without the aid of a stethoscope, so let's listen to an example now. Stridor is a high-pitched, continuous musical sound with a harsh, grating-like quality. It most commonly occurs during inspiration, and the sound we have just heard was an inspiratory stridor without the use of a stethoscope. We'll now listen to an inspiratory stridor with the use of a stethoscope, and this sound can be likened to the phrase caw-ah. To illustrate this, let's listen to another real-life example. Stridor is caused by narrowing of the airways. This produces two effects explained by the Bernoulli principle. Number one, airflow accelerates through the narrowing and becomes turbulent. And number two, airway pressure drops, leading to dynamic airway collapse. Airway collapse and turbulent flow cause airway wall vibrations, which produce audible vibrations that we hear as a stridor. Dynamic airway collapse occurs after the airway narrowing in the upper airway and is more significant during inspiration. In expiration, collapse does not occur due to positive airway pressure. The Bernoulli principle is reversed in the lower airways. This means that the collapse occurs higher up above the narrowing. Collapse does not occur during inspiration, but is seen in expiration as the airways naturally become more narrow. These dynamic changes in the airway lead to a very useful clinical sign, and that is that the timing of the stridor in the respiratory cycle can give an indication as to the location of the airway narrowing. Let's take a closer look at this and learn some technical terminology. The respiratory tract can be divided into the extrathoracic and intrathoracic airways. The extrathoracic airways includes parts of the respiratory tract that are not in the thorax, whereas the intrathoracic airway includes those parts of the respiratory tract that are in the thorax. Obstruction in the extrathoracic airway, such as the proximal trachea, the laryngeal or the pharyngeal parts of the upper respiratory tract, produce a stridor during inspiration. Obstruction of the intrathoracic airway, such as the lower portion of the trachea or the bronchi, results in a stridor during expiration. Biphasic stridor is produced by severe obstruction just below the level of the vocal cords. This type of stridor occurs both in inspiration and expiration. We'll now take a look at two examples of stridor using an animation. In the first example, there is an extrathoracic obstruction of the upper airways. This will produce an inspiratory stridor. In the second example, there is a subglottic obstruction in the extrathoracic airway. This will produce a biphasic stridor. In this one, we're going to start slow and then speed up to real time. In summary, stridor is a high-pitched, continuous, musical sound with a harsh, grating quality. It can occur during inspiration, expiration, or can be biphasic, meaning that it occurs in both inspiration and expiration. Stridor can be heard without the use of a stethoscope. But if you do auscultate, stridor is often louder over the neck and central airways. It is caused by obstruction of the extrathoracic or interthoracic airways, which produce turbulent airflow and dynamic airway collapse, resulting in audible vibrations that are heard as a stridor. There are many causes of stridor, which can be divided clinically based on whether the stridor is inspiratory, expiratory, or biphasic. Let's take a brief look at some of the causes of stridor. Stridor generally occurs more often in children, and inspiratory stridor is the most common type. Viral croup, foreign body, and laryngomalacia are the most common forms in children, but there are others listed below, and these mainly can be grouped into inflammatory or infective swellings, tumours, or congenital malformations. Expiratory stridor is less common and can be easily mistaken for wheeze, so consider stridor in a patient with wheeze-like symptoms that are not responding to treatment. Causes of expiratory stridor include bacterial tracheitis, intrinsic and extrinsic airway obstruction, and malacia of the trachea or bronchi. Finally, biphasic stridor occurs due to foreign body, masses within the larynx, vocal cord paralysis or dysfunction, or subglottic stenosis due to post-extubation or tumours. This brings us to the end of the Lung Sound series. If you've enjoyed this episode, please help me out by liking and sharing with others, because this helps to promote the content of the Learn Medicine show and helps others to learn about the great world of medicine and all its fascinating and intriguing concepts. Do not go anywhere, because the next two episodes will be about testing your ability to identify lung sounds, first with flashcards and then with medical legend. Stay tuned, I'll see you in the next episode.